Hello students, welcome to the class of teacher Minal Pereira. In this video, we will study about the solved example of the lesson Reflection of Light. These are the solved example given on page 114. Okay, so let's begin. Now, the first example. If the reflected ray makes an angle of 60 degrees with the normal, this is the reflected ray, this is the normal. It makes an angle of 60 degree. What must be the incident ray make with the normal? So we have to find the angle that is made by the incident ray. Okay, so what is given to us? The angle of reflection R is equal to 60 degrees and we have to find what is the angle of incidence, that is I. Okay, but according to the law of reflection, what we know? The angle of incidence and the angle of reflection are equal. So, angle I is equal to angle R. And what is the value of angle R given to us? The value is given to us as 60. That means, obviously, angle I or angle of incidence is also 60. Okay, so the incident ray will make an angle of 60 degrees with the normal. Okay, so this is based on the law of reflection of light. Moving further. If the angle between the incident ray and the reflected ray is 90 degrees, what are the values of the angle of incidence and angle of reflection? Now, we have been given the value between the incident ray and reflected ray as 90, and we have to find what is the value of angle of incidence and angle of reflection. Okay, so together the value of I and R, that is angle of incidence and angle of reflection, is given to us as 90. Okay, now according to the law of reflection, angle I is equal to angle R, that is angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection, and together it is given to us as 90 degrees. Okay, so therefore this R we can replace with I because both are equal. So I plus I is going to give me 2I is equal to 90 degrees. Now here this 2 is in the multiplication. So when it goes to this side, it becomes division. So 90 divided by 2 is equal to 45. So angle of incidence and angle of reflection are 45. Okay, so together angle is given to us as 90. We know that angle of incidence and angle of reflection are equal. So we can take, add this up, and we can get the answer as 45 degrees. Next, the angle between the plane mirror and the incident ray is 35 degrees. What is the angle of incidence and angle of reflection? Okay, a very similar example. Now, look into this diagram. In this diagram, line PQ is a mirror. Then, we have the incident ray AO. This is an incident ray. Line ON is a normal. And ray OB is reflected ray. Okay, so from this figure, angle POA is equal to 35 degrees. So this angle POA is given to us as 35 degrees. Okay, and angle PON is 90 degrees because it's a normal. Okay, now this angle PON, this is made by two small angles. Which are the two small angles? One is angle POA and another is angle AON. So this big angle is made up of these two small angles. Okay, so now therefore when we add these two, we are going to get the big angle. Now one of the angle, this angle is already given to us as 35 degrees and the addition is 90. So then how do we find this angle? Okay, now here this is addition. So when it goes this side, it becomes subtraction. So 90 minus 35 is equal to 45. So we get this angle of, 55. So we get this angle of incidence is equal to 55 degrees. And then according to the law of reflection, angle of incidence and angle of reflection are equal. So when angle of incidence is equal to 55 degrees, then angle of reflection will also be 55 degrees. So both the angle of incidence and angle of reflection are 55. Okay, so when such questions are given to you children, you can draw a small rough diagram. Okay, the total angle is given to us, one angle is given to us, and from that we can find the value of another angle. Then, what angle will the reflected ray make with the mirror if the angle of incidence is 40? Okay, again referring to the same diagram, we have the angle QON, that is this big angle, that is 90 degrees because it is a normal. This angle is given to us as 90 degree. Then angle of incidence I is given to us as 40. Okay. So what is the angle of incidence? Okay. The angle of incidence N. Okay. The angle of incidence AON is given to us as 40. Then according to the law of reflection, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So, therefore, angle NOB will also be 40 degrees. Okay, try to understand. Angle of incidence is 40. So, according to the law of reflection, angle of reflection is also 40. Okay, now what we have studied in the previous example, the same thing we are going to do here. This big angle is made up of these two small angles. So, addition of these two, that is angle NOB and angle QOB, is going to give us this big angle QON, which is 90 degrees. So, now angle of reflection NOB is equal to 40 degrees, and this is already given to us as 90 degrees. So, again this 40 goes here. So, 90 minus 40 degrees is equal to 50 degrees. So, the reflected ray will make an angle of 50 degrees with the mirror. Okay, so draw a diagram and then remember the laws of reflection. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection, and the same principle we are using here. Now, moving further to your textbook, question 7. Solve the following examples. First one. If the angle between the plane mirror and the incident ray is 40 degrees, what are the angle of incidence and reflection? Very same example that we studied just now. Okay, so the angle, this angle is given to us as 40, and we have to find the angle of incidence and angle of reflection. Okay, so we know that this angle of incidence and plus this 40 is equal to this big angle, that is 90 degrees. Now, together is 90 degrees, one is given to us as 40. Okay, so therefore 90 minus 40 is equal to 50 degrees. So therefore angle of incidence and angle of reflection, because both are equal, we have angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection, that is 50 degrees. Okay, very similar that we studied in the previous example. Then again, if the angle between the mirror and the reflected ray is 23 degrees, what is the angle of incidence of the incident ray? Okay, so again the same thing here. Now this angle is given to us as 23 degrees, and again we know that this big angle is, which is made up of these two small angles, it is 90 degrees. One of the angle is given to us as 23 degrees. Okay, so therefore 90 minus 23 is equal to 67. Okay, so therefore using the law of reflection, we have again the angle of incident and the angle of reflection, both are 67 degrees. Okay, so I hope these sums are clear to you. Okay, you can solve it in your notebook. Okay, these are easy. You just have to remember the laws of reflection here, and just one principle or one thing we have taken here into consideration, that the big angle that the mirror makes with the normal, okay, is made up of two small angles. So, when one angle is given, by subtraction, we can find the other angle. Okay, so I hope it is clear to everyone. Thank you very much.